Oh, what's up, everybody? We got ourselves a fancy intro now. Welcome to episode 2 of Mavs Vault. I'm your host, Jason Zone Fisher. I'm fired up to be here and to be joined, as always, by Machine is in the house. You know him from the Ceiling is the Roof podcast and everything when it comes to Mavs content. Machine, how you feeling? I'm jealous of that jacket because my old school Mavs, while this is cool, printing is a little weird. It's very long.
Like I said, people's chest in 1980 used to be down here for some reason. They wanted it on the belly, but I'm doing great, man. Happy to be back. I did think this was the fishing show, so I'm not prepared for this one at all. Thank God we got some great guests. But yeah, thanks to everyone checking us out again. Really excited about episode 2. Episode 1 was a flying success, I'd say. So
absolutely. And of course, not last but not least, let's give it up for Bobby Corrala. You know him from the Numbers on the Boards podcast. You see him on the big board at Mavs games. I follow him on Twitter for all of my Mavs content. Bobby, you're looking good. You are looking like vlogger ready. You got the mic, the headphones, the Dirk in the background. You're feeling good.
Yeah, we got all sorts of guests. So we got Dirk, and we have KP left home alone, Lucas Skywalker, and then I'm assuming that's Dwight Powell as Mr. T, maybe? I don't really know. But yeah, it's a big party over here.
That's good. You've done some decorating over the last
absolutely
week. I like that.
Absolutely. Gotta look good. Gotta look good. Look good, feel good, you. Play good.
Thank you for being here, Bobby. I know you're busy, and you too, Machine. You know, it's been a busy week in the NBA, and here on Mavs Vault, we're going to talk basketball, but we're also going to focus on the world of collectibles because it is booming right now. From basketball cards to NFTs like Top Shot to sneaker collections, game-used tickets, pieces of memorabilia. We're going to get into all of it week in and week out and have fun guests every single week. We were joined by Maxi Kleba of the Mavs last week. Week in and week out, we'll have some current players, some former players, all different fun surprises. And today, we've got a great surprise. You guys, if you're a Mavs fan, you've heard of these two because they know the Mavs inside and out, and they know the collectibles world inside and out. Let's give it up for Mike and Cash Sirois of the Collectible Network. Give it up. Yes, what's up, Mike and Cash?
How are you doing? How we doing?
Major step down from Maxi, sorry.
Ah, crap, you invited my dads on.
There was only one Maxi. There's two of you guys.
Exactly, Bobby. This is the 2-for-1 special here today. Now, Mike and Cash, you know these guys from the Cirque du Sirois show on 1310 The Ticket, and they started the Collectible Network. So first, let's get started. I mean, you guys have been huge basketball fans for years, involved with the Mavs in a variety of different capacities, and obviously talking all things sports on The Ticket. But how did you decide to get into the world of collectibles, and what made you want to start the Collectible Network?
We started off, this idea has all really happened in a really short period of time. It started in November, actually, as just a germ of an idea, because of these, sports breaks that are happening in the sports card industry. You know, the Luka card goes for $4.6 million or whatever it's sold for. And I'd been collecting into the 80s. My brother and I grew up collecting cards and, you know, made us look back in our collection and then just think about, you know, is there a place that does card breaks with a little more production value? They've been around for years. It's like we invented the genre or whatever, but we wanted to up the production value a little bit. We've made videos for the Mavs for the last 10 years. Some of the some fans might know the funny videos with music, movie trailers, things like that. So we know the ins and the outs of entertainment in the NBA. We know the Mavs and we know the collectible space and we know production. So it's like, okay, maybe if we do this, and then we add some original programming, things that we're working on over the next couple of weeks. You're going to see some really cool stuff as in the original programming space on the Collectible Network. We're like, you know what? There might be something that nobody's put it all together. And the fact that the Collectible Network is available and hasn't been patented tells you that nobody had thought about it. So Mikey and I kind of joined forces, and we've been the snowball's been rolling downhill ever since.
That's awesome. It's really cool. It's been fun
He's
to
the
follow
brains.
You and see what you're doing.
The looks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mikey's the funny in the looks.
I would like to first say thank you to any official Mavs thing from letting me back on. I think it's my first time back since Steve Chivera let me run the Mavs Twitter account for a game. I believe I killed that bit single-handedly. I don't think anyone's done it since. As I was saying, our guys were leading the league in most dribbles. just making up stats. And halfway through the game, he's like, write that you're on this, and then write this. And they just kind of, we wrote it out, and it's, I haven't been on since, so I'm just glad to be back.
Well, nice. We're glad to have you here, and you haven't been banned yet from our Twitch channel, so this is good.
TikTok.
Nice. Yeah, the clock is ticking. Cool. So I'm curious. I mean, you guys said, you mentioned you've been collecting, you know, cards and in this world since like the 80s. What were some of the first packs that you would open or pieces of memorabilia that you would collect that you remember that got you into the hobby way back when?
I would think we're from South Florida originally, Miami, and back then the Dolphins were literally the only professional sports team in the state, which is kind of bizarre to think about because now there's multiple teams in every league you can imagine, but all we had was the Fins. So we were probably a little more football card heavy, and 1984 or 1983 was when Dan Marino came into our existence. So we were no doubt on the hunt for anything Dan Marino in those first packs. So I would guess football. And then, you know, that may have even led us into baseball and all the rookies, the standard rookies that we all have in our club, in our attics right now that are worth very little. But just searching for those rooks and everything. And Cash was a big Mets fan as well. So he was definitely on the hunt for some of those 85 Met names.
As a matter of fact, I've got a card that I can show you right now. Ooh. That this,
yeah,
is,
I set him up for that.
That was nice. That was professional. Yeah, this card is the first card that I ever had graded. And I got Dwight Gooden to sign this rookie card. This is a 1984 Topps traded rookie card that I actually stood in line at the mall in Miami when I'm, I don't know, 12 years old to get him to autograph that for me. So this is probably one thing in my collection that I will never get rid of. It just means too much. I started collecting a little bit before this card, but when Strawberry became a rookie in 83 and then Gooden came around in 84 and then they went and won the world title in 86, I was hooked on baseball cards after that.
Cool. That's awesome. You know, everyone has, some people invest or get into the hobby as an investment because you can flip it, you can make a lot of money. Obviously, you guys are doing some of that with the Collectible Network, but there's such a value that certain pieces and items have because of the nostalgia, because of what it means to you, just like that, what you said. And there's, you know, it's pretty priceless. And that's one of the reasons that I got into the hobby too. Nostalgia over my childhood and certain cards and moments and memories that I hold dear. And now I think it's reached a point where generations are passing it on to the next generation, which is really cool to see too. It's awesome.
And that's what we found in our breaks that we do. There's a lot of dads that are doing it with their kids. They'll send pictures on at Collectible Net is our Twitter handle, and you'll see a picture of somebody watching like a Mavs game with my break on their laptop and their kid kind of watching both. And it's just like, that was, if the internet was around back then, that would have been me with my dad. So it is cool that way.
And that also helps me remind me to watch me language when they send the picture of a little kid like 10 inches away from the screen. I'm like, oh, that's right. That's right.
That's good.
Easy. We're not doing marbles tonight.
Just like,
this is not, we'll see. Not Monday marbles.
Until I get my full screen, I'll do whatever I want.
Y'all are going to be opening some packs later on your own stream, but also we're going to be opening something pretty soon on this one too, right?
Yep.
And we're going to be giving it away to a very, 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 very extremely lucky viewer.
Yeah, I've got a box of Origins, Panini Origins, that we're going to crack open here in a few minutes, and then you guys can give it away to somebody in your chat, whoever you want.
Amazing. That's awesome. Well, thank you for doing that with us. That's going to be really fun and exciting. And thank you, everyone, for tuning in. This is the show that pays to be a viewer because you can walk away with something really valuable, something really fun. We're going to have some giveaways every single week and throughout tonight's show. Some surprises are in store. Now, for all the fans watching out there who maybe don't know, could Mike and Cash, could you guys describe what a break is? Because you've alluded to it a few times. I know you'll be doing it over on the Collectible Network after our stream as well. But how does a break work?
You know, it's funny that you mentioned that, and I'm glad you did, because once I fell down the rabbit hole, I got the feeling that anybody that's in sports cards already knows about these breaks. Mm-hmm. And then a lot of people have reached out to us since we've started doing it, and they don't even understand, and they didn't know that these things existed. So it's like in radio where there's a new listener every, you know, 30 seconds or every 60 seconds. It's good to go over that. A break is basically an opportunity, and we're going to break Panini, Prism, a big hobby box, some draft.
Hold on up real quick. I want to zoom in on that. Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Yeah, so this is a really high-end box of cards, and then three draft picks that are full of LaMelo Ball rookies, Anthony Edwards, all kinds of stuff. So we're going to open three of these and one of these. And the idea is that that is very, very expensive stuff. And it takes a lot of money to buy all of this stuff and have it all for yourself. So a break is an opportunity for you to, let's say you want the Mavs. Let's say you want these Mavs rookies. Let's say you're hoping for a Dirk insert or something like that. You can purchase. There's an eBay auction for each NBA team from the Hawks down to the Wizards. And you can buy the Brooklyn Nets. You can buy the Mavs. And then what you'll do is you'll watch our stream and we will break each pack, open them so that everybody can see each pack as it opens up. And when we have really big hits with rookie cards or inserts, numbered autograph cards, put them in plastic, protect them really good. And then every card from your team from that break gets shipped to you. So it's just an opportunity for you to not have to spend a vast amount of money and still maybe get the card that you want.
Yeah. The element of it I like is I'm a bit of a gambler, and you never know what you're going to get when you open a pack, and that's really fun. So it's a fun way to watch the break and sort of invest in a team, hoping that I'm going to get that LaMelo rookie if you have the Hornets, or Anthony Edwards rookie card for the Wolves, or whoever that rookie class is, maybe your favorite team, your favorite players. You want those Mavs, like you said. You want a Luka Prism, you know, red prism. There's all these different levels of cards that have real value, it's a fun way. You never know what you're going to get. It's pretty exciting. Are there certain teams that in this year's class tend to go for more or be the highest valued, and there are others that maybe you see as a bargain out there when there are breaks? It's like people aren't really targeting this team, but that's what you would do if you were in their position.
Well, I think it's just like back in the day when you would collect, you're looking for rookies. So whatever team has the hot rookie right now, Minnesota Timberwolves looking for Anthony Edwards, and LaMelo, whose face is on the cover of everything, obviously make the Hornets a lot more valuable than they probably have been in years past. I mean, the Knicks have a couple rookies quickly, and Obi Toppin, who are solid players and, you know, are kind of shooting up the odds rankings. And then what's the Houston Rocket kid, that the rookie that So he's one that even a couple months ago no one was even looking for. So the Houston Rockets were going relatively inexpensively, and they've been sort of ticking up as this dude starts to creep his way into the top five rookie of the year, possibly, you know?
So he came out in 2018 and then had to go to Australia or something. I think he even played with LaMelo when he was there. There was some kind of connection there. And one of the assistant coaches in that country is now an assistant coach with Houston, so got him there. So this is his first year in the league, and he wasn't even in some of these early boxes because he was a nobody rookie in quotes, but he is in this box as an insert later on, and he's been somebody that people have been looking for.
Yeah, I think another fun thing is that you're really investing in players too, because we don't know who the best rookies are going to be for 5, 10, 15 years maybe as their careers develop. There's always late bloomers in each draft class who really become standout players in year 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So if you believe in a player, or you believe a guy just hasn't gotten minutes, like the center from the Atlanta Hawks, Okongwu, maybe he becomes an excellent player in a few years. He's just not getting the minutes right now. Or a point guard like Killian Hayes from the Detroit Pistons, who had an injury and a setback. There's opportunities to invest in teams or players that are a little more under the radar if you're thinking of making a long-term investment, perhaps.
And there's one that Bobby, I know, I heard talk about. I think you were on the radio, or maybe it was at a podcast I was listening to. You don't remember.
So much content.
There's so much stuff. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Alexei Pokuševski. That's right.
Pokuševski. Okay. Yeah. Tell me about him, because he's a guy that I basically made fun of his rookie card for the first half of the year, because the dude – The picture, it does him no justice. He looks so skinny. It's like he needs a cheeseburger. Yeah. And then I hear
his elbows. Like, what is that?
So, tell me about him, because he's somebody that people are taking notice of.
Yeah. So he's the youngest player in the NBA. I think I'm not even sure he's 19 yet. Like, he's really, really young. And he weighs like 6'11, 7 foot. And maybe weighs
Bobby and I.
I mean, I'm like 180, 185, and I might have like 10 pounds on him.
You weigh more than him, I think.
Yeah. He is very, very skinny, and so he kind of looks funny, but he's so skilled. I mean, he makes some passes. Like, even some of the plays that he made whenever the Mavs played the Thunder don't even do him justice. He makes some incredible passes. He can shoot threes, handle the ball. He runs the floor in transition, but – He does things that are like so awe-inspiring, and then literally the next time down the floor, we'll send a pass that's just like sailing into the fifth row. So he is like, he's wild, but he's so much fun to watch. But this guy's got so much potential, and so like from a rookie start, rookie card perspective, like 5-10 years from now, he could be like an all-star caliber player. So
okay,
he's a really high potential guy.
Yeah. And he's somebody again. Oklahoma City is not going for a whole lot. You can get in these breaks, and you can get yourself a really amazing card of his, or you can invest in him directly right now, and you can get his rookie cards for a reasonable price compared to Edwards and Ball.
That's not a bad idea. I mean, I'm not going to compare him to Nikola Jokic, but when Nikola Jokic was a rookie, people weren't really talking about Nikola Jokic, and now he's a leading MVP candidate. So there's always these diamonds in the rough that it's really a long game. And that's what's fun about the NBA. You're investing in players and teams as fans, and cards and collectibles are a way to translate that investment into something you can actually hold onto, which is pretty cool.
Yep.
Yeah, all right, awesome. Machine, let's get you involved. Do you have any questions for the guys here?
What's the hottest pool you got, Cash, this season?
This season, you know what? I didn't bring it with me after talking to you a little bit about that. We opened, we had a world premiere. Our friends at Panini, excuse me, sent me a box of absolute memorabilia, and they allowed us to open it the night before everyone was allowed to put it out. And so it's on our Twitch stream, or it's on our YouTube channel, I think. The video exists. And so we just opened it and gave it away to somebody. And as we're going through it, we saw that they had Luka and Dirk signed cards. And I have not seen a retired Dirk signed card. And they had it to number to 99, number to 50, number to 20, so on and so forth, and number to 1. And we go through the packs, and I'm going one by one the way we're going to go with this Origins box in a second to create a little bit of drama. And all of a sudden, the blue is the right color. And you can see the bottom of the logo. And we're like, Luka or Dirk, Luka or Dirk. And it is a retired Dirk autographed card, number 4 of 5.
Wow.
So dang. Unbelievable that the first box that we cracked to premiere to everybody, and it's in Dallas. I mean, it could have been in any town. It could have been any box. Could have been any star. And I pulled Dirk, and I freaked out. I mean, I don't hold back when something like that happens, because it's kismet. It was magic.
That's awesome. That's really cool.
You give it to him. That's the only right thing to do.
Give it to Dirk?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, no. He's giving me enough. Right? Yeah.
He doesn't like it. I remember when I saw him. This one. No, I don't need it. Is there a card? There's no card cash with Luka and Dirk, a dual sig yet, is there?
I gotta think that I have not heard of one or seen it, but that would be a hell of a 101.
That'd be incredible. Yeah, yep. Exactly. Well, maybe we can help make this happen. There's some powerful people in the collectible space. Like,
Tracy Hackler, marketing director at Panini. You're welcome.
Wow, there you go.
Looking at you, Panini.
Yeah, we're calling you out by name. That's right. Now, can you also explain to everyone the process? We're going to do this break in a few moments here, and you get a card. You get a card that has a lot of value. You want to get it graded. How that process works, can you explain a little bit about that? And then also what's happened with PSA, which is kind of the leaders in this,
yep.
How they've been so backlogged, they have stopped taking new submissions, mm-hmm. and how you think that might affect the industry over the next 6 months to a year.
So this is a nice way for me to, you know, unveil an interview show that we're going to start here on the Collectible Network called Unpacked, that I would love to have each of you on at some point. We're just putting the graphics together now, and we're going to debut it here in the next couple weeks. And one of the first guests that we're going to have is probably going to be Jeremy Murray, who's the president of Beckett Grading here out of Dallas, who they and PSA are the two biggest grading services that there are in the industry. And I was speaking with him a couple weeks ago when the PSA announcement came down, and they have no plans to obviously slow anything down. They've kept their prices relatively the same, but it's a big hit, and the ripple to all the other people that you don't think about. There's a lot of people in the industry that go to these card shows and things of that nature, and this influx of this new product and everybody wanting this new product and wanting those new cards graded has just created an avalanche that PSA basically doubled or tripled their prices just a month before they stopped taking cards in. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there was a lot of people saying that was going to hurt their business, but maybe half the cards, twice the price, it's the same amount of money. But what turned out to be the problem is they would have three times more cards in the final month before the prices changed than the three months that they had beforehand in total. And the avalanche of cards created a situation that they couldn't get enough people to grade and therefore couldn't get the cards turned back to people. So it's going to be interesting. You know, there's other grading companies that are going to pop out and have an opportunity. It's going to be interesting to see how it shakes out.
Totally. Now, when you're looking, let's say a lot of people have done over the last year, myself included, gone through our old collections, you know, from the 90s, all my cards I went through, oh, I've got all these Michael Jordans or Shaquille O'Neal rookie cards or all these cards to figure out what has value and not. But what's hard for me to determine is what is this card worth getting graded? Not just that it's a good card to have, but the corners look good, the centering. What are the sorts of things that customers, you know, or fans at home who are going through their collections can look for to try to determine themselves if it's worth getting a card graded?
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned two of them. There's only four categories, really: surface, right, centering, corners, and the fourth one that Cash is about to say out loud.
Bench press.
Pizzazz.
Yeah.
Hot dog. Moxie.
Centering, edges, corner, surface.
Edges. So, yeah, I mean, it's...
What's the difference between an edge and a corner? I guess is the...
Is that a joke question?
The perimeter.
That's a joke question.
I mean, corner sharpness, edge. That's the one thing we all know from way back in the day, is that's the first thing you look at. It's like the corner's got to be good.
Corner sharpness.
Yeah, and that's the first thing that'll get dinged. Okay. Like Mike always has his Luka classy man. What's it called? First off.
Class X. With an X. No, I'm just kidding.
He's going to get it tattooed on his chest here soon.
He carries it with him everywhere he goes.
Right. I just carry it in case I run into somebody who can grade these things. I'm just doing it always.
You ask every person that you interact with, do you work for PSA?
Yeah, what would you say?
Just take it.
8.7?
Take it to the front of the line. 8.7? Just give me a quick...
I will say that as a rule, you're asking about old cards. As a rule, I talked to somebody who actually grades cards, and I don't know if it's personal preference or, you know, just industry-wide. The most important thing or the thing that takes the most off of a card immediately is centering. Mm. So if a card is not centered properly, that is something that will hurt your score. So if you got great corners and got great edges, but the thing's off center, maybe you want to save the dollar and not get it graded.
All right. Well, while I have you two here and you're experts, now normally on this show, we're going to do a little show and tell of some of the fun things in our collection, but I'll do a little preview of one of them. The other day I was opening just an old pack of basketball cards that I had lying around, and I pulled this pretty rare, unique card. It's a Sam Vincent card. Now, no one really knows who Sam Vincent is.
I've got that card. There.
But what's interesting about this card is that is Michael Jordan wearing jersey number 12. There was one game in Michael Jordan's entire
career. That's not his number.
He didn't wear number 23 or 45. His jersey was stolen minutes before the game, and he had to wear number 12. So it's a really cool card, a piece of history, and people have been tweeting about it. It's been going for thousands of dollars. I freaked out when I pulled this card. This is amazing. That's a cool story, history. However, when determining, do I get this graded, if you look at the centering of the card, it's clearly the borders are not centered. Yeah. So, because I have experts here in the building, is this worth getting graded?
Well, one other problem that I see the centering, but I can also see in pen where Jason wrote 12 on because that's going to hurt the surface as well. So that's two strikes on that.
That's right. That's true.
I thought you were going to pull a Gene Parmesan and pull out the stolen jersey too.
Oh, yeah.
Just be like, and here's the jersey.
That would be worth. Yeah.
I was like, damn, Jason.
Yeah,
got him again.
That would be good. I wish. Yeah, by next week, maybe someone out there has that stolen jersey. They can, you know, hit us up. I'll send this card for the jersey.
Like the answer for that one is don't get it graded because you know for a fact your centering is going to dock you too much to make it probably worth whatever the best grade it could be. You know?
And a way to do it is look at that card, search it on eBay, items sold as perfect graded, right?
Yep.
And if it's a perfectly graded, it's a $110 card, and you already know that yours is going to be a 9, then at least, go to a 9, look at an 8, and then you see it's a $30 card or something, and then why spend $20, $25 to get a card graded that's going to be worth $30? So that's the way that you would kind of do that.
Well, thanks for the good news. Okay. No, but thank you. That is helpful for anyone out there who's in this space, who's going through their cards, and you say, oh, I got a great card. Well, you do have to look a little closer. It's not just about getting the card. It's also about the centering. And damn you, Sam Vincent and NBA Hoops, for not centering this card. But yes, I hear what you're saying, for sure. Well, you guys, I know you do have to get out of here soon because you're prepping for your big box break, which you told us a little bit about. First off, where is that going to be taking place? So anyone who's watching here will be able to participate or watch it go down live.
Yeah, so follow us at Collectible Net on Twitter, the Collectible Network on Instagram, and obviously Collectible Network on Facebook. It's our Twitch stream or YouTube. We stream live to both. And if you follow us on Twitter, we'll put out the link and as soon as we go live. But yeah, if you go on Twitch and search the Collectible Network, you'll find us. And 8 o'clock tonight sharp, we're gonna crank it up and rip some fire.
There's also a command, just exclamation point collect. It'll take you to Collectible Network's Twitter. So
damn. Really?
Sure. Yes. Right now. Wow.
Didn't even know
right
that.
Now.
Awesome.
Well, hey, hold on. Before Cash starts ripping, I have come bearing gifts.
I like that.
You're out of luck, Jason and Bobby, because you're not my best friends that I've known forever, but Machine certainly
We're your second and third best friends.
That's fine, but that doesn't
look at my centering, bro.
If it was centered properly, maybe. But I don't know if it's a secret or not, but Machine and his lovely wife, Jordan, are welcoming a fresh babby into the world, I think in a couple weeks here, right?
Yeah, about a month. Right. Four to 6 weeks away, yeah.
So I have a gift.
I didn't do anything. You can put that for me.
Full screen. All right.
Full screen.
All right, not best friend. Here you go.
All right. Look at it. It's a little baby thing.
Oh, wow. Oh. Haven't seen one of those before.
Run. Oh.
Hey. Yes.
Blockbuster night.
Look at that thing.
Wow. Is that 8-bit?
It arrived, and I'm like, well, this can't be right. No, not even a fresh baby can fit into this. It's the smallest thing I've ever held in my hand.
Oh, that is amazing.
That's awesome. That is great, man.
For your future boy or girl. And one more gift, more of a sincere one. This is for you, Michael. And this is hard for me to get rid of. But I heard you talking last show, and I know you're
$20,000.
This suitcase.
Almost.
Hold on, Cash. This is hard. It's BGS 9.5, which is pretty much the best grade that Beckett gives. Sean Kemp.
Goodness. Oh, wait. That's sick.
Oh, snap.
The glare is so powerful. It's graded so well, the glare.
It's white hot.
There it is. Hold it there. That's good.
I love that he's listed as a sinner, too. That makes it even more fun.
I know that's your favorite, man, and this is graded absolutely perfectly. Jason, if you'll notice the centering, and then hold your Sam Vincent card up.
To compare.
All the differences. But that's for you as well, Machine, as a congrats.
That's awesome.
For making a babby.
The kid is not getting that one.
Jason, you and I got to be better friends with Mike, and then I got to have a baby.
I made a baby. And my centering's off. I got nothing out of it. I'm getting
the illuminated shark no matter what. So about it.
Well, thank you, Michael. That's so sweet of you. I really appreciate it. That's awesome. Yeah. I think my kid has more band shirts than I do by at this point. That's tough. It's tough.
Yeah. I figured someone else is gonna get RTJ and you can't have too many because they're gonna be everywhere from what I understand.
Yep.
Yeah,
that is awesome. That's really nice of you. Thanks for bringing gifts for the whole class to share. But it's okay. That was very really cool of you to do that. But you guys are giving brothers, and you are going to give back to our community right here.
Yep.
So I know one lucky fan is about to win big as you're about to rip open this box of cards, this pack. Tell us a little bit more about this box that you're about to rip into. What it's worth, what it's called, what we can expect.
Yeah, so these boxes retail for somewhere between $575. This is going to be one pack, 7 cards in this pack, 2 memorabilia or autographed cards on average, could be something we don't even know about, could be a redemption card that you don't even get right now. You have to scratch something off and send it into Panini, and it's sent to you in plastic. There's no way of knowing. So are we ready?
Opening it is, opening.
Yes. Oh, yes. No, so, all right. So here's
Bobby,
how you get it.
Yes, Bobby, how's it going
to
work?
You have to follow the channel. So you have to follow Dallas Mavericks on Twitch, which you probably already do if you're watching, but if not, you should. And then you also have to, in the chat, type the word origins, and you have to spell it correctly. And the onus is on you to go out and learn how to spell origins.
Two I's.
And if you do that correctly, are there really?
Not O-R-I-G-I-N-S.
Oh, I thought you were saying like O-R-I-I-G-I-N-S.
No.
Yeah, so you have to learn how to spell origins, and then you have to type origins into the chat. And you have to follow Dallas Mavericks, and then we'll announce the winner. And also the winner of last week's giveaway, Night Owl 6410. We whispered you. You didn't respond. So, dude, check your whispers, and we'll give you that Luka card. Without further ado.
I'm coming for it.
Let's give away some cards.
Whoa, let's do this.
There are living creatures in here. All right, start. Let's go. Let's do it.
Right. Good luck, everybody. Right. So this is what a break looks like. We bust now,
he's not cutting the cards in half there. That's merely the plastic on the exterior.
Oh, my God.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you.
I like it.
I do that every time we do an actual break. He wants to strangle me.
We got Bobby's got puppies for the break.
I don't know whose dog this is.
All right. Oh, well, this is a beautiful box and packaging.
Look at that. Look at that. I just love that sound.
I know.
See ya. Okay.
It smells good, too.
It does. It's like, I can smell like a new car.
I'm going to smell my box.
Good luck, everybody.
Cool. Yeah, someone is going to win this pack.
Somebody's going to take this whole deal home. And I have got, for dramatic purposes, a spacer.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Got a spacer.
This is how we build the drama.
I love it.
Ja Morant. Dude. Base card, but a sick base card. John,
what a monster.
That's a great start.
Fantastic.
Wow. One of my favorite players in the league.
He's very, so cool.
Very freaking cool.
So fun.
All right. Probably like base card number two. DeAndre Hunter.
Okay. Promising.
Solid player. Mm-hmm. Young player. Getting better.
Okay. Now we don't.
In conversation. Improved until he got hurt, so his stock is on the rise.
Yep.
All right. At this point, anything could happen.
Yes. At any point, anything could happen.
I saw it.
Ooh. Russell Westbrook.
Ooh.
Russell Westbrook.
He doesn't play for them.
It says Washington Wizards on the bottom. There we go.
Yeah. Wow. So that would be a Washington Wizards card.
If you did a break and I had the Houston Rockets, I would have been real excited only to read the fine print.
Yeah, no, like, it's the team on the card.
Nice.
Spacer
gave it away.
I know him.
Number 20 out of 20 freaking five, Luka Doncic.
Incredible.
Unbelievable.
Incredible.
Dude, this is just like the freaking Dirk
thing. Luka Magic.
It is Luka Magic.
How do I type origins in here? How do I type origins in this chat?
We'll ban you from it, Mike.
Unbelievable.
Man,
this
that
is
awesome.
Amazing.
Wow.
We
wow.
saw him open the box in the back. There's no planting this moment. This is
incredible. Incredible. Wow. You're like David Blaine.
I'm exactly like him in every way.
All right. The chat better be going crazy right now.
I can't believe you're missing a freaking Luka. Numbered six.
20 of 25?
Yes.
All right. I'm gonna pull from the bottom.
He was probably 20 when the photo was taken.
Gonna pull from the bottom. Oh, and a base! And a base! What is going on?
Oh, my God. What are you doing?
How did you do this?
How'd you saw the lady in half?
That's not how this
kidding me?
Are you not impressed?
Is that just base or is the shimmer?
Oh my God.
Yeah, there's some weird color going on there.
No, it's a base.
Wow.
A base and a numbered to 20. I can't believe that just happened.
What? That's nuts.
On the Dallas Mavericks official Mavs vault, this is what happens.
Collectible Network.
Open the vault.
Get another one.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay.
Don't even say oh my God.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Another Luka.
No, we got something incredible.
What? So
this is an Aaron Naismith rookie autographed card to 49, which is cool enough, right? That's cool enough.
Pretty cool.
But I'm gonna have to move on because of what's happening next.
What is happening?
I can't believe
that's it. Boban.
If it's another Luka,
Mikey,
I'm gonna drop it.
It's a redemption card. Okay.
Okay. So, like I said, sometimes you get cards that are so cool. Now, it's not always somebody that's amazing, but it's a good valued card that they didn't want to put in the pack because they didn't want it to get injured on its transit to you. So they're called redemption cards. Mm-hmm. So we get to find out together. This is so for the drama purposes. This is the best possible thing.
I'm freaking out.
So now we're going to look and find out together what this card is. And whoever gets this, you'll see it in a second. It's basketball, guys.
Okay.
It's
basketball. Okay.
It's basketball, guys.
Good. Good. Yes. Keep going.
All right. Origins.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
The card set is Origins Autographs Silver Ink.
Okay.
So it's an autograph card, but it might not be, it's probably not a rookie card. So maybe it's a veteran card. Card number 32. Don't know. So here it is. Danny Avdia. So it is a rookie.
Avdia.
Okay.
That is awesome.
So, wow, what a great freaking pack. So, yes, he's just turned 20 as well. So, whoever gets this, you scratch this off, go to paniniamerica.net, put in the code that's underneath there. 6 months later, something like that, the card comes encased in plastic.
Wow.
And you've done it. What an amazing.
That was an insane pack of cards.
That's nuts.
You're opening all my lottery cards. You're scratching all of them, Cash, from here on out.
That is, I can't believe that just freaking happened.
Cash, you have opened thousands of packs of cards.
Yes.
Can you describe that pack? Seven cards. What just happened?
Okay, well, what I can tell you, did you see my hand shaking? Did you hear my voice? I promise you, this happens on the Collectible Network every single time. I'm not faking it. That was freaking awesome. And the energy that comes through my fingers when I see something that I know everybody wants to see is insane. That was bonkers.
Oh, man. That was epic. What do you – any guess on what you think the most valuable card? Is it that Luka card, the 20 of 25?
Yeah, probably. The Naismith rookie, he's going to have to do something. But the fact that this is numbered to 25 – this is numbered 20 of 25 is probably the most valuable card. Luka's white hot. He's amazing across the league. So, wow.
Two Luka That's cards, awesome. One of them limited to 25, and two autographed rookie cards. One you got to redeem. It's so high.
Yes. That's
That is amazing. Again, follow the channel. Type Origins in the chat.
Wow.
You're welcome, right now. Twitch.com.
Do that right now. It's twitch.tv, Mike. Do that right now. Follow Dallas Mavericks. Type Origins in the chat. Y'all want to do the giveaway right now?
Yeah, draw one.
All right, nervous. We're gonna do this in 1 minute. So you have one more minute, fellas. Before we do it, I guess.
Y'all
are doing a stream. We're gonna raid your channel afterward as well.
That would be awesome. Yeah. We're 20 minutes out. So if the raid doesn't work or whatever, come find us at the Collectible Network at twitch.tv and have some fun because we're gonna. Evidently, I got the fingers tonight. So let's get this happening.
I gotta watch y'all stream too. It's gonna be insane.
That was perfect. There was no better pack to open given what we got here. All right,
you want to do this thing?
Twitch channel.
Kevin, come on over. Come on over.
On Mavs so, Vault.
All right.
We need to cut y'all loose. Y'all can get going, Cash.
I want to see who wins.
You want to see who wins? Okay.
So there's no allegations of chicanery or anything. This is Gavin. Gavin's going to – well, Nightbot is going to do the drawing, but Gavin is going to – man, Nightbot, what to do because man has triumphed over machine for thousands of years. So let's do it right now.
Ready?
Pull.
I'm scared.
Do the magic.
While he's doing
– Go, Gavin.
All right.
Did Luka win it?
R.E. Valdez 12.
Yes.
R.E.
Valdez
12.
That is your winner, R.E. Valdez. Congratulations.
Yeah, R.E. Valdez, you win an off-center Sam.
you're giving it away.
Hey, here it is. Here it is.
Yes.
There
it is. Yes. 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 Wow.
Congratulations.
Hey,
well, you joined the Mavs Vault. R.E. Valdez, a big winner here tonight. And thank you to Cash and Mike from the Collectible Network for spreading the wealth with our Mavs fans here on the Mavs Vault. Thank you for your time, your insight, your knowledge. We're all going to go check out your channel for more breaks and more good luck. That was epic.
Awesome, man. Thanks so much. Let's do this again. I got all kinds of fun stuff to show you guys.
Love you, boys.
Thank you, guys.
Bye-bye, boys.
See ya.
Oh man, I'm riding the high from that. That was pretty exciting. That was epic. Only 7 cards. 2 of them were Luka cards, and
feels
one
like I just drank a Surge for the first time back in junior high.
That was amazing. Yeah. Artie Valdez, we'll whisper you, by the way. We already whispered you, so go ahead and respond back to us, and we'll get you hooked up.
Screw a whisper. We're going to shout it. That was crazy.
Screaming from the top of wherever we are.
That was epic, and there's something about that moment, that is why I love cracking packs and the part of this hobby. You just never know what you're going to get or what could happen, and that genuine excitement – to me, it takes me back to my childhood of opening a pack of cards. It's like that exact same feeling. And even when it's not for us, we weren't going to win it, I was nervous and fired up the whole time.
Did you used to have friends in the neighborhood who collected cards as well? Like you would bring like your case and you would trade. Like trading cards were trading cards in my neighborhood. Like you bring your case, but there were some that were so good. I'm not taking them to the road show today, boys. Right. Like they stay underneath like the mattress, right?
Totally.
Like they're untouchable. That Luka card, untouchable.
You know, untouchable.
Can I tease the other thing we're going to give away?
Sure.
Hold on. Let me tell this quick story first, and then you can, because we're going to do another giveaway in a second. But just to your point there, Machine, I used to have, you know, kids had lemonade stands. I would set up card stands in front of my house and have people come in the neighborhood and do this. And it got to the point where, you know, everyone growing up probably had the local card shop you would go to. It was called Popularities, where I grew up, and I would go there, and I convinced the owner to let me have one case for my cards. And I would actually sell cards there, and I'd give him a pretty big commission. And it was brilliant for him, because it was great for me as a very entrepreneurial fourth grader to have this racket going officially. But
you're doing all the work for me.
Because any money that I made, I just bought more cards from this guy. So it was a perfect deal. All right. But that's awesome. Giving away more stuff because we love you, our fans. So Bobby, tell them what else they could win here tonight on Mavs Vault.
All right, so I got to preface this by saying I don't have a second camera like Cash does, and I also haven't recently gotten a manicure, so I'm going to try and show as little of my fingernails as possible. But at the very end of the stream, we'll be doing one more giveaway. There will be a keyword again, so you guys got to stay following Dallas Mavs and get ready for that. The keyword for this one is going to be Dirk, because we're giving away a Dirk. Wait a minute. There it is. We got to get it to focus. Let's go. A Dirk sign. This is an autographed card. And this thing right here.
Yeah.
Well, that's his autograph. I just spoiled it with my fingerprints. And that is also a piece of a game-worn shoe. So in this card, in that photo, Dirk is holding up a shoe that he wore in a game. And this little patch of blue you can see is kind of where the Nike swoosh is.
Sick.
Where that piece is. So we'll be giving away a Dirk autographed card to a very, 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 very lucky viewer, except for Ari Valdez. If we roll you again, then we can't give it to you. Sorry. But to someone else. And again, the keyword for this one will be Dirk. We'll give that away at the end of the show.
Wow. That card exists. There's a handful of them that exist. That's the only one that's autographed.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, we have the rest of them. We have the others. They're all here. This is the only one with an autograph. Now, this one, it's not numbered or anything. But it's obviously like a legit thing, and the autograph is real and everything like that. So it's a very valuable card.
With a piece of the shoe, too. What part of the shoe do you think?
Like a sole almost.
Smell? I'll report back.
Smell like dirt?
It smells like the goat is really what it smells like. But yeah, it's kind of tough to tell, but this doesn't really focus. But like on top of the Nike swoosh.
Yeah.
There's that little patch of blue. I think that's where it's from, or it could be from the inside. And if it's from the inside of the shoe, that means it made contact with his socks, which made contact with his feet. So basically, like, this is a little piece of Dirk.
And Dirk had a hangnail that game. There could be Dirk DNA.
Oh, there 100% is. There 100%.
Wow, perfect.
Enough to clone him.
Yeah, I think this is a good segue into a little show and tell, because the three of us are pretty big collectors in various things. So we like to bring something to the table to share with the group and to share with all of you. So Machine, you went to the video archives last week. Were you digging through there for this week's show and tell, or what would you like to present to the class?
Yeah, there's so much there. If we get too bored in this, I did acquire this.
Oh,
We can pull the Chuck Norris lever at any time, like on the old Conan show. But let's save that for next week. We already got I can't do better
How
than
are you
Cash.
Gonna pop
what I just can't happened. Do better than what Cash just did. Yeah. So I dug into the archive again. There's three options that I put on the run of show. Bobby, I think, narrowed it down to the one he wanted. His vote was the original news package broadcast piece from the day we became an NBA franchise.
Oh, wow.
In 1980. And it's done by the great George Reba. If you're from Dallas or you watch Dallas News, you know who George Reba is. Works for, I think, Texas Motor Speedway now and the Cowboys. But he was the sports newsman, literally from like 1980 to 1990. You'll recognize the voice, just iconic voice. But this has some footage in it that I don't think 95% of Mavs fans have ever seen. Like, I put a piece together last year for the 40th anniversary, used some of this, like little tiny pieces, and people were like, what is that? I've never seen that. And so it's from the initial press conference. And my favorite parts, you'll be able to pick them out pretty easily, but Don Carter he's a walking soundbite. He's just awesome, man. But without further ado, here's the original news package from 1980, WFAA, George Reba.
Roll it.
We are proud to have Dallas
Larry O'Brien
part of the National Basketball Association, and we are confident that the fans of Dallas will be supportive.
NBA Commissioner Larry O'Brien made official today what everyone already knew. Dallas will have a franchise in the NBA for the 1980-81 season. Their name will be the Dallas Mavericks, same mascot now being used by the University of Texas at Arlington. When asked about that conflict, Norm Sanju replied,
"We had heard that. Very bluntly, I lived here a year and was not aware of that until after the selection was made. But I did know that. Now I do know that by now, yes."
It's no accident that the team colors will be blue.
Norm, by
the
way, is like the reason the Mavs.
Yeah.
Don Carter was the original owner. Norm Sanju was the GM.
Yeah. Norm is such a G. He's like, I had no idea. I was here for a while.
When he followed the announcement to formalize a certificate of franchise with the commissioner, Donald Carter, Doug Atkins, and Norm Sanju all signing the agreement.
The colors just sublime.
Oh, wow.
Donald Carter is currently the controlling owner of the franchise.
Love
he
that
owns
collar.
Half of the team and promises not to step in as long as the two vice presidents are in agreement.
As long as my family is interested in the game, you can bet your bottom dollar their daddy's going to be there. And Norm and Doug are part of my family. I don't plan on them being able to get out anytime soon. If they do, they're going to get out naked.
The next step for the 3 days with the naming of its first coach. George Reba, Channel 8 Sports.
Nice.
Oh, that is awesome.
Dude, there's those two quotes are just like part of my, it's canon now. Like I just say them around the house and like to friends. I'm like, daddy's going to be there. And I'll just be like, nope, you're going to get out naked. That's how that's going to work.
That is perfect. That was really a perfect piece of video to say the Dallas Mavericks, welcome to the NBA. The cowboy hat, the Texas drawl, those sayings.
Passing around the cowboy hat, like Larry O'Brien's like,
Yeah, that was epic. That is perfect. That just felt like 80s, late 70s Texas right there. That was
cool. It has all of it, man. It has Don Carter being the most, doing the most, being the funniest guy, just live wire. It has Norm Sanju being like, nah, I had no idea, but now I know. Respect to them, respect to them, yeah. Respect to them. It's like the most Norm Sanju thing ever.
Could these be NFTs one day? Could this be a moment? Like
now we're talking.
I've been on that.
The daddy's going to be there NFT.
Yeah, daddy's going to be there NFT. Let's start the bidding in the chat. Yep.
One of 10.
Wow, yeah. That was epic. All right,
you might enjoy that.
You awesome. Bring treasures, some gems from the archives every week. We appreciate that. It's a trip down memory lane and learn something new. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, you're not gonna get out, or you're gonna get out naked. So
yeah, exactly. Bobby, what do you got for us? Last week you showed us the collection that you stole from the Dallas Mavericks.
Acquired. Yeah, right. So I got two things for you guys. Well, two and a half things for you this week. So the first,
and he brought a dog.
Yeah, no, look, that was at one point.
Yeah, I honestly don't know whose dog that is. I ended up with it. So this is an entire team signed here. I got to get it kind of in front of.
Cool.
This is like all inverted. I am struggling.
That's okay.
Signed by the whole team from the 2006, I believe. Let me see. The 2006 Tux and Tennies Gala. So it kind of preceded Mavs Ball. Mavs Ball, by the way, coming up soon. Tickets are on sale now. So definitely check it out. But Tux and Tennies was kind of like the original Mavs Ball. And this is signed by the entire team. And so I want to get it up close.
Yeah.
You can see like
I see why they changed the name.
I don't know who that is on the well, they wore tuxes and tennis shoes. So do you get it? Yeah. So I don't know who that is on the top right there, but I know that's Josh Howard and Marquise Daniels.
Yep.
Then of course you have
it's top right say number 40 on it.
40, it looks like. I think maybe someone in the chat can do some Googling for
us. Yeah. Pull up the old Mavs roster. That could also be number 10, Daryl Armstrong.
Daryl Armstrong? I was gonna say Daryl Armstrong. That's what the name looks like. Yeah. One of my favorite Mavs players.
One of my favorite people. Like, yeah, dude, on the road, DA is the most fun.
That's cool.
You have Avery Johnson, of course, the head coach of that team, Dirk Nowitzki, the GOAT. That's Josh Powell, Jerry Stackhouse.
Oh, wow.
Jay Powell. 33, who would that have been?
Brendan Haywood? No.
Not on the team. I think 33 was Josh Powell. Number 44 was Adrian Griffin, by the way.
Cool.
DJ Banga. Sorry, all the
Banga.
Assistant coaches. Let's keep going. Devin Harris is in here. Jason Terry is somewhere in there. So, really cool, really cool.
Bobby, where do you keep this or where do you display this?
It has been in various places in various apartments that I've lived in since I acquired it from my parents. So I don't know if they know I have it. But
all in the same apartment complex, though. You just move units like every 2 years.
I have been known to do that. But, as of about a week ago, it was on kind of my bedroom wall. Because it's pretty cool, man. I mean, this
that is 15
years old now. Okay, so the other thing. Yeah, absolutely. Very elegant.
Yes, elegant.
So this last thing. So last week I brought a little warm-up shooting shirt that you can see right over here.
Yes.
This week I brought the same thing, only it's green. And –
nice.
It belonged to a very special player. Now, here is the back of the
Mavs man.
Player.
Oh, well, we don't know his backstory.
And here it is from the front. And now right up here.
Love it.
You can see on the tag on the inside, number 89. So that's the year that it was distributed. Then number 4 is handwritten on this, and it wasn't handwritten by me.
Michael Finley.
No, that's Derek Mike Finley was Harper? Like 10 years old in 1989. No, so number 4, let's see, does anyone in the chat know who was number 4 on the 1989 Dallas Mavericks? Does anybody know? I do.
Brett Favre.
The Mavericks, not the Packers. They sound kind of the same, and they both wear green.
You're right. My bad.
Does anyone in the chat know? No, not Steve Alford. That's a good guess. Not Brad Davis. No, Brad Davis wore number 15. Rolando Blackman says Tyriggs. No, he wore number 22. Let's see. Josh Powell, number 33. Someone cheated. Firebird Justice. I know, but I cheated. I had to cheat too. Here, I'll pull it up. So I had to go to trusty.
I would have known who it was if I didn't see you pulling it up earlier.
Yeah, they don't sponsor us yet, but basketballreference.com. I don't know if you can see it, but so number 4 that season belonged to the great Adrian Dantley.
Yeah.
Might have forgotten as a Mav because he spent most of his career with other teams, of course, but I believe most commonly with the Jazz. And then I think he was also with the Pistons. I want to say he came to the Mavs in exchange for Mark McGwire.
Yeah, he was good.
Very wrong about
very
that.
Good player.
But yeah, he was awesome. An awesome player, and he was here for about a year. This shooting shirt belonged to Adrian Dantley. And I did some research. Gavin and I were wondering, what is Adrian Dantley up to these days? Guys, it turns out that like he saved almost every dollar he ever made in the NBA, so he's set for life, but he's kind of bored because he's still like 65, 66 years old, still in great shape, everything totally healthy. So he's a crossing guard for a middle school in Maryland. He just helps kids get to and from school every single day.
That's awesome.
And there was a news package about it, and they were like, dude, why are you doing this? You're a millionaire, you're an NBA player. And he was like, because I just want to help. I'm kind of bored. I love working. I just want to help these kids. You know, I've saved a couple of them because of whatever, like it's dangerous getting to school. So he just is a crossing guard. So shout out to Adrian Dantley for just being a good dude.
Well, I think we found our next guest. We got to get Adrian Dantley.
We got to get him on the show.
To one, you can show him that you have his, you've acquired his shooting shirt. Mm-hmm. And two, to figure out what he's doing being a middle school crossing guard. That is crazy.
He just wants to. I think
he's been wondering where that shirt is for like 30 years.
Yeah. He's pacing around back and
maybe
forth.
Maybe we shouldn't bring him on the show because then he's going to want it back.
No, I want to get him on the show.
I don't have the heart to say no to Adrian Dantley.
We're going to chase him down, I think. I think he's going to be on a future episode. This is going to be good. We're getting
Adrian Dantley because of those socks that look like they're about that thick, and he wears them up to his knee. And then the sock with the muscle thigh, like that's a look. Adrian Dantley's got a fit.
Let me. I want to show that picture again.
My man does not miss leg day.
Check. I don't think I can zoom in on this. I might be able to. Let's see.
Well, you know what you're going to have to do later is you're going to have to do a little Googling and try to find Adrian Dantley, like Google shooting shirt. And photo match. You want to do a photo match with any game-worn memorabilia, jerseys or shoes or shooting shirts. See if you can find him wearing the exact same thing that you have.
Oh, I need to.
That's your homework assignment for next week. We'll see for show and tell. Maybe you've got the photo to go with.
Never a big homework guy. Never a big homework. But I'll see what I can do.
All right.
What'd you bring, Jason?
Where are we? All right. Well, you know, I did bring some cards. Obviously, I showed my Sam Vincent card. I was very excited when I got it. And then obviously not so excited to find out that it's a valuable card minus the centering. I also recently got my first Luka card. I don't have any Luka rookies, but it's kind of a unique one. It was from a pack of Panini cards. It's a vanity plate, a Luka Doncic vanity plate card.
Nice. Like you get at the car wash gift store.
It's pretty much what this card is. Yes, exactly. It was registered February of 1999. I'm guessing, is that when he was born?
He's a February kid, so yeah.
So February 99, that's when his license plate was registered is what the card's going with. I don't know.
Let's weird of Texas to do that.
Cool card, or is this like as lame as a custom vanity plate in a store? I don't know.
I think it's cool because it has Luka on it.
Yeah.
I agree.
Trivia, guys, do you know the number two song in America the day that Luka Doncic was born?
99?
The number two song?
Smooth by Santana featuring Rob Thomas.
I don't think it had come out yet, but it's a great guess. Of course, Baby One More Time by Britney Spears. How can you guys just not know that?
All right. Well, that's good. That's good to know. That's very valuable. Now, the other cards that I brought, now this year, the card market we talked about really took off over the last 12 months. The world shut down because of COVID. We were all home, quarantined, and there were no sports on. And we were all watching the Last Dance documentary. And Michael Jordan cards started going through the roof. So I went through my collection and found hundreds of Michael Jordan cards. I did find this card just the other week that I opened in a pack. It's a pretty cool card. You know, it could be worth a few hundred dollars. But here's my prediction. There will be another player whose cards are going to surge in value when a documentary about him comes out. And there's one that is currently being edited and it will be out, I believe, in the next year to 18 months. And that's Irvin
Insider Magic. Info.
He's got an incredible story, obviously. He laid the groundwork for the NBA along with Larry Bird for Michael Jordan and what the league became as one of the biggest stars and the first superstars in the league. And I really think that, and I meant to ask the Sirois brothers this, if there's a player to invest in, I kind of think Magic Johnson could be one of those guys. So recently I just opened a pack of cards last week and I got in the same pack, very similar to our double Luka pull that we got, both of these Magic Johnson cards in the same pack. His All-Star Game card and his Lakers card there. So, you know, again, I don't think these are worth thousands of dollars, but I do think cards like this, if you have in your own collection at home, are going to continue to go up over the coming weeks, months, years, especially after the Magic documentary comes out when people really remember how iconic it was and how memorable the story arc of Magic Johnson's career and life has been. So I would recommend if you're investing in sports cards that Magic Johnson might be someone you want to look into.
If you want to talk about rookie performances, like we're talking about Luka rookie cards.
Oh, yeah.
Magic Johnson, game six of the NBA Finals, his rookie season started at center.
Yep.
Center, and he scored like 42 points.
Yeah.
He's a point guard.
It was unbelievable. Played center. And Kareem got hurt that series, right? Yeah. And Magic had to do it all.
As a rookie, and they won the championship. Now imagine if Luka like started at center against, you know, freaking who they got, Anthony Davis.
Right, right. Yeah, it's wild. The things that he did, and that was obviously just the start of his career after coming off of what he did in college, right into that, and the incredible run he had with the Lakers, winning multiple championships, meeting Bird in the finals, and then what happened in his personal life, having to retire from the game early, and how he has become such a huge figure in the business world, in the community, and still is to this very day. So Magic Johnson is another one of these sort of larger-than-life figures that to own a piece of him, even as small as a basketball card, is a cool thing for me, and I think for people out there too. Is it? Good guy to invest in, you know, if that's how you're looking at it. So him and Larry Bird saved the league today for this, yeah.
Yeah, him and Larry Bird saved the league. Like, that's not debatable at all. Yeah. And I know we forget about Magic because everyone likes guys that shoot threes now.
Right.
Just watch any game from when Magic was in his prime and tell me that dude is not dominating every second he's on the court.
Yeah.
Dude, what an incredible player. Like, We've lost touch, and he's almost like, you know, he was on TV a lot. I think he even had like a late night talk show at some point. Just became like, you know, the guy. And we forget, okay, that was one of the greatest players that's ever touched a court anywhere.
Exactly. And that's why I think when this documentary does come out, people are going to – young kids are going to learn that for the first time, and others are going to remember that or recall that, and there'll be a much greater appreciation for Magic Johnson, the player and the person, than there is even today. And he still is beloved, you know, obviously. So I got a lot of fun stuff to share, but we're going to be here every single week doing Mavs Vault with different guests, different show and tells, different box breaks, different NBA Top Shots, something we haven't even talked about on today's episode, but I know we're all really big fans. They keep releasing packs. We've been lucky enough to get some of them. We'll be doing some breaks and having some guests on who are big in that world. There was some big news recently, right, Machine, in the Top Shot world?
Yeah, so there is a one of, I think, 40 moments of LeBron doing the Kobe dunk, right, which is the, you know, scissor kick, like reverse two-hand dunk.
Yeah.
And it sold. It was the highest price, whatever you want to call it, highest grossing Top Shot ever. 4 days ago, $387,000.
That's crazy.
For a Top Shot moment.
Wow.
And if you're going to get one, that's probably the one, right? Sure. They haven't made like the alley-oop off the backboard from the Dwayne Wade one or anything. And they haven't made like whenever they make the Luka leaner, you know, the push shot against Memphis, that's going to be awesome. Or like the Kawhi falling out of bounds. Like, there are moments that you just watch and you're like, they're made for Top Shot. You know, that's one
of them. Absolutely. Well, actually, let's talk about that, because we're talking about collectibles, but we talk about real life too in basketball. And what was going through your mind, because it's been a week since that Luka leaner, the crazy three-pointer to win the game. What was going through your mind when that play happened? And really the end of that game too, because that was a game the Mavs should not have won. And there were so many chances for them to lose, but they found a way, and then for it to be encapsulated in that shot. I know you were watching every moment of it. Bobby, let's start with you, because you were tweeting about it as well. What was going through your mind?
I mean, it was just an amazing shot, you know, but they've run that same exact thing for Luka, that same play end of game so many times. And in fact, they had done it a couple games before against the Spurs. They only had, I think, like 0.3 or 0.4 seconds on the clock, and so Luka got it and just threw a heave. But so many guys have seen the replay of Luka beating the buzzer against the Clippers, where he gets the inbound pass against Reggie Jackson and he steps back for three. And so many guys have seen him make those shots, that shot in particular, so they know, I'm going to sit on that step back. So whenever Luka gets the pass, you can see Dylan Brooks really lunge out at him, like almost daring him to take the step back because he thinks he can get a hand in his face and stop him. But Luka, like, the most amazing thing about that play was his presence of mind to know, I can catch this, split the double team before Valanciunas can get over here, recognize that Dylan Brooks is sitting on the step back, and get a shot off, even though it wasn't really a shot. It was more like a prayer. But, like, he can make that play happen all in 2 seconds. Like, just to have the presence of mind to know to do all that stuff is amazing. And then, of course, once the shot went in, I was thinking, okay, that was definitely a two. Like, there's no way that was a three. And then you finally see the replay. His foot is clear behind the line. And that whole thing, again, just kind of adds to Luka's mystique of, like, this is a guy who has, like, the ultimate flair for the dramatic. And so I guess it's not surprising that he was able to get his foot behind the line. It's not surprising that he was able to make a floater, because he just does that stuff all the time just for fun. It's a shot that he has taken before games like a billion times. Like, literally every time he warms up, he's shooting, like, crap shots like that that I'm sure drives Rick Carlisle crazy. And then he sees him make it in a game, and he's like, okay, now I understand why you shoot that shot all the time. So, yeah, it was just an incredible display of, like, athleticism and talent, obviously, but also, again, just the basketball IQ and the presence of mind to know exactly how much time he has, to know exactly how he was being defended. And he was able to get a pretty clean look despite having less than 2 seconds to do it with the game on the line. It was just an unbelievable play.
Man. And yeah, there's a machine. Right? What was it like for you watching that? And also, we heard Rick Carlisle after the game say, Luka practices shots like that all the time. Mm-hmm. And when you're around the team, he's always doing trick shots. So have you seen him doing this stuff?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Like, there's a couple that he, like, adds into his routine that you're just like, oh, he's goofing around tonight. Yeah. But if you're at every game and watching him pregame like we do every single time, that's practice.
Yeah.
It's either the half-court shot, the heave. He tries the fading away from the basket towards the half court line, like, launch before every game. And so he gets, you know, he's just calibrating, just getting it down. So you've seen him do it a lot. And there's honestly, I make my wife watch maybe a quarter of basketball in an entire season. Like, she's so lucky I'm not like, watch all this. I sat her down and I go, watch this final minute of this game.
Yeah.
Grayson Allen missing both the free throws. Right. Like, that game's over. There's a margin of points that you're just like, okay, that's a tough one. We came up short. We weren't in it. We gave too many possessions away. When he missed both those free throws, I was like, yo, what? The door's open. We can win it with a three. And he did it maybe the game before, Bob, where he got the last second shot. He's literally running away from the basket he's shooting at. And he heaves it two-handed. And it got close. And he's made those in practice before. And just the idea – and the wherewithal and the maturity of him knowing I've hit this left wing fadeaway step back three enough now where it's in people's minds. They're going to overplay it. They're going to try to trap me on it. I'm going to step through. And he does that. He does that step through now whenever he gets fouled a lot. Like, whenever a guy's on his hip, he'll do the step through in the soft toss. Never does it from behind the 3-point line.
Right.
I'll add that. I've never seen him do that. So to do it, and then he goes in, and I didn't know how to react. I was like, that's a two, or it was too late.
Yeah.
It was after the buzzer. And then they keep showing it, and Followell's freaking out. Harper called it too. I wanna give Derek Harper some props. He called it. He goes, I want to hear what you're gonna do after this shot goes in. He hyping Followell up. And Derek Harper called it. Dude, it's unlike any other game winner I've ever seen. And he's done that five times now.
It's pretty incredible that with Luka, with so much talent in the league, that any game you watch, something new can happen. It doesn't matter if you've watched 10,000 NBA basketball games before. With him, it always feels like you're going to see something you've never seen before. And he keeps doing it. And that was amazing. That's a play that we'll see for generations to come, literally. Yeah. It was pretty special. Speaking of pretty special, I think it is that time of the show for one last giveaway to reward someone else. So by typing Dirk in the chat right now, we are going to give away that limited edition, the only autographed version of the Dirk Nowitzki card with a game-used shoe on the card, autographed. You have to be following the Dallas Mavericks. You got to follow our Twitch channel here and type Dirk in the chat, and we will bring in the bots to decide who wins this final giveaway of the night here on Mavs Vault.
Mike, how do I make this hateful message disappear? All right, there we go.
You brought it up. Well, no one else brought it up.
Yeah, because I initially said type origins in the chat, and then I was like, yeah,
No. That's the old one. That's the old one.
Artie Valdez has already taken home two Lucas. Yeah. Someone is about to take home a Dirk. So we'll give everyone just another minute or so to
these are some legit giveaways that we're doing here.
These are incredible, yeah.
Yeah, so please be sure, in addition to all of this, stay tuned, follow all of our channels as well. You can follow me at Jay Z Fish on Instagram, Bobby, Bobby Corella.
Bobby Corella, yeah.
Bobby Corella on Twitter, at Instagram, and Machine. You're all over the place too.
Machine Sports on Twitter, Machine DTX on IG.
So follow us. We'll be posting obviously a lot of Mavs content, but also all about Mavs Vault, about upcoming episodes, upcoming giveaways, upcoming guests. We got a lot of fun in store for you over the coming weeks as the collectible world continues to just take over and dominate. We're going to have a lot of fun here and share the fun with you through giveaways like this Dirk giveaway that we're about to do as we bring in the powers of Price Waterhouse Cooper with the sealed emblem.
Did he just try to give card away to Derek?
The winner is Michael H25. Michael H25.
Michael H25. Congratulations.
You are the winner.
You Michael won an autographed Dirk Nowitzki card. Oh, show that card one more time. A piece of a game winning shoe. Autographed Dirk 41. Let's go. Look, he's even got the 41 logo.
Look at his profile pic. I made that.
Hey.
I made that.
No.
You made that.
This guy made that.
No.
Yeah.
Nice. I made it.
Epic.
I like seeing people with profile pics of artwork that I've made. That warms my heart. Nice. You may never know that, Bobby. It's okay.
Oh, wow. Jeez. All right.
Well, okay. He deserves to win then. Another reason he deserves to win. Exactly. Congratulations to him.
We'll whisper you and get your contact information and everything. So just be on the lookout for a message from Dallas Mavericks or from Gavin. One of the two. Maybe
Bobby does a lot of whispering. A lot of whispering.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm talking into the microphone right now.
Like one of those.
That's a different Twitch channel.
Yeah, that's a different channel. That has
change our category to ASMR if you want.
That's right.
Also, again, I don't know if you're listening, Night Owl 6410. You are the winner of the Luka card from last week. If you're watching this now, respond to your whisper. Don't make us do it again.
Well, I think next time's the last time for that guy. Otherwise, we're going to recycle that, put it back out in the ether.
I might acquire that Luka card myself.
Yeah.
How do you go check out the Collectible Network? Exclamation point collect.
Exclamation point connect. Mm-hmm. You can also go to their Collectible Net or the Collectible Net on Twitter. But the command collect will take you to their Twitter account. And then also you can follow them on Twitch at the Collectible Network. All one word and everything. And as soon as our broadcast is over, we're going to raid their channel as well.
Sweet.
Awesome. Well, I think, real quick,
Takurusu asked, do you guys have a regular schedule? We have done both streams on Tuesdays so far. However, obviously the Mavs do have games sometimes on Tuesdays. Do we play next Tuesday? Yeah. That's back-to-back West Coast. You're right. Mm-hmm. So it will be a different day every week depending on the Mavs schedule. But typically, we will try and announce it sooner than the day of so that y'all can, you know, plan to be part of the stream and everything. We're going to try and give stuff away every single week. So you definitely want to follow the channel. We have a lot of really cool stuff planned for the channel. In addition to Mavs Vault, we have some other shows that we're hoping to roll out as well. So it's going to be really fun. It's going to be a really good time. But, we can't say for sure when the next day we'll stream is again because we do have games, but we'll make an announcement as soon as we have it knocked down.
Tentatively next Thursday. We'll see how everyone's schedule looks.
Okay.
Perfect.
We'll see.
We will let you all know if you follow all of us, follow the Mavs, you'll be able to see when we're going to go live next with more giveaways and the next edition of Mavs Vault. It will probably be Tuesdays except for next week or any Tuesday that there is a Mavs game. So check your local listings, and we will be beaming in live to your living rooms. But thank you, everyone, for being here for our second edition, and a big thank you to the Sirois brothers. Check out the Collectible Network by just using !collectibles. It should take you, pull up their channel, their Twitch, their Instagram, their Twitter. You'll be able to see it all. And Thank you to Machine and Bobby for being here with me again, sharing some gems from your personal archives and collections and Mavs history. It was a lot of fun. I can't wait to do this again next week with another guest, more giveaways for you, the fans. Thank you guys for being here and watching. Stay safe out there and go Mavs, everybody.